I am very happy you are here. I hope you and family are keeping safe. May I ask you to subscribe? The painted stork is a large wader in the stork family. It is found in the wetlands of the plains of tropical Asia south of the Himalayas in the Indian subcontinent and extending into Southeast Asia. Their distinctive pink tertial feathers of the adults give them their name. They forage in flocks in shallow waters along rivers or lakes. They immerse their half-open beaks in water and sweep them from side to side and snap up their prey of small fish that are sensed by touch. As they wade along, they also stir the water with their feet to flush hiding fish. They nest colonially in trees, often along with other waterbirds. The only sounds they produce are weak moans or bill clattering at the nest. They are not migratory and only make short distance movements in some parts of their range in response to changes in weather or food availability or for breeding. Like other storks, they are often seen soaring on thermals. This large stork has a heavy yellow beak with a down-curved tip that gives it a resemblance to an ibis. The head of the adult is bare and orange or reddish in color. The long tertials are tipped in bright pink, and at rest they extend over the back and rump. There is a distinctive black breast band with white scaly markings. The band continues into the underwing coverts, and the white tips of the black coverts give it the appearance of white stripes running across the underwing lining. The rest of the body is whitish in adults, and the primaries and secondaries are black with a greenish gloss. The legs are yellowish to red, but often appear white due to their habit of urohydrosis, or defecating on their legs, especially when at rest. The short tail is black with a green gloss. Males and females appear alike, but the males of a pair are usually larger than the female. The downy young are mainly whitish with gray bills and blackish facial skin. The juveniles assume a brownish plumage, and like most other storks, reach breeding condition after 2 to 3 years. Like all storks, they fly with their neck outstretched. They often make use of the late morning thermals to soar in search of foraging areas. Like other storks, they are mostly silent, but clatter their bills at nest, and may make some harsh croaking or low moaning sounds at nest. They feed in groups in shallow wetlands, crop fields, and irrigation canals. They feed mainly on small fish, which they sense by touch, while slowly sweeping their half-open bill from side to side, while it held submerged. They walk slowly and also disturb the water with their feet to flush fish. They also take frogs and the occasional snake. They forage mainly in the day, but may forage late or even at night under exceptional conditions. Hoping you liked this video, and we'll look forward to your next visit pretty soon. Till then, take care and be safe.